out. I call out a woman. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come here, Shalom.
Come
here, Shalom.
Come here, Shalom.
I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
Part of the lecture, which is
the
Bible's not a white man's book. So now we're going to go into this part. Here you see a white man with the Bible. What we're going to prove now that the Bible is a black man's book and everything in the Bible is for black people. Now give me the next slide. Now this is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 21. It says prove all things. So today we're about to prove that the Bible is a black man's book. True to popular belief, most people believing that the Bible's a white man's book, and really that ain't true. People who tell you the Bible is a white man's book, they've never read the book. When they tell you it's a white man's book, you tell them, show me something white about the book. They can't show you nothing white about the book, because the book ain't a white man's book. The Bible says prove all things. So today we're about to prove all things, and we're about to prove that this Bible is a black man's book. Now, this is King James. King James was also a black man. People think King James wrote the Bible, but King James didn't write the Bible. He was the king at the time that authorized the translation. Oh. So King James had 47 scholars who translated the Bible. Oh. And King James was a black man, he wasn't a white man, yep. Like what you've been taught. The reason people think he's a white man is because the white man's the devil the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
And what the white man likes to do is, he likes to whitewash images, everything great, he likes to make out is him. Even that's why with the new movie they brought out, the Egyptian movie, the whole cast is white, because the white man makes out his everybody. Next slide. Now this is Jeremiah chapter 14 verse 2. It says Judah mourneth. Now Judah is the Jews. It says Judah mourneth. Now when you look at those Jews in Israel, they ain't mourning. They own the Diamond District. They own Walt Disney. They run the world. Here it says the Jews are mourning. They're not mourning. You know why the Jews are mourning? Because they're in captivity. They're in a land that's not theirs. They have to go to the job center. They're in jail. They're getting murdered in the streets. Read on.
And the gates thereof languish.
And it says, and the gates thereof languish, meaning there's no protection for these people. These people's got no decent leadership, no protection. And this is why things like this can happen. A white policeman can come in your neighborhood and murder you because the gates languish. That don't happen to them fake Jews in the land of Israel. Read on.
They are black.
What color are they?
They are black.
So here it's telling you that the Jews are black. It's very clear. It says, Judah mourneth. Now, when you look at how black people are living, we're mourning. We just about can pay the bills, just about can make ends meet. That don't fit them so-called white Jews, because they own the world, they've got all the money in the world, they own the world banks and stuff. Mm-hmm. Now black people, we don't really own a thing. We're mourning because we're in a land that ain't ours. We don't know what to follow, what to do. That's why we're mourning. Read that again.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish.
And it says, and the gates thereof languish, meaning there's no protection for these people. These people get murdered in their neighborhoods. Trayvon Martin got murdered by the white man. Our gates language, people can come in our neighborhoods, murder us, and do whatever they want to us. Read on.
They are black unto the ground.
And it says, these people are black unto the ground. Now, white people ain't black. Now, this white boy here is not black. So, that's how you know. If this was a Jew, he would be black. This white boy is not black, he's not a Jew. Next slide. Read it for me.
John 4:22. Ye know. Ye worship, ye know not what.
Now this is when Jesus Christ was speaking to a woman who thought she was one of us. He told her, ye worship, but you don't know what you're worshiping. Read on.
We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews.
The salvation is what?
Salvation is of the Jews.
So Jesus Christ's salvation is of the Jews. Salvation meaning to be saved, meaning rulership. It said salvation is of the Jews. Now the last slide we read, it said the Jews were black. So if Jesus Christ is saying here salvation is of the Jews, who is Jesus Christ saying salvation is for?
Black people.
Say that louder. Who's Jesus Christ saying salvation is for?
Black people.
See, exactly. So Jesus Christ was saying here salvation is for black people, because we need saving. We the ones who's being murdered. Salvation ain't for everybody. Give me the next slide. Now, this is going to be some salvation for the black man running rulership. You're going to have a white man on your cotton field. You're going to have a white man picking your sugar cane. You're going to put a muzzle on the white man. Same thing they've done to us. And we're going to be a black man with a whip once Jesus Christ returns and gives us that power. You know why? Because salvation is of the Jews. Next slide. Read that for me.
Hebrews 7 and 14. For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
Like I say, it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, meaning it's evident that Jesus Christ is of the tribe of Judah. So in the previous scripture we read that the Jews are black, and it says Christ sprang out of Judah. So what color would that make Jesus Christ? That would make Jesus Christ the black man. So who's this white boy right here? Who's this white boy right here? If it's saying Jesus Christ came out of Judah, and we read that the Jews are black, read on.
Of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Yeah, now read Daniel chapter 10 for me.
Daniel 10 and 5. Then I lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen.
Now this is talking about Jesus Christ. Read on.
Whose loins were girded with fine gold of Ephraim.
Jesus Christ had a war belt around his midsection which was gold. Read on.
Verse 6. His body also was like the beryl.
Read on.
And his face as the appearance of lightning.
Read on.
And his eyes as lamps of fire.
It says his eyes was of lamps of fire, because when you drink wine, your eyes turn red, and Jesus Christ drank wine. Read on.
And his arms and his feet like in color.
It says, and his arms and his feet like in color. Now it's going to give you the color of what color Jesus Christ's arms and feet was. Read on.
To polish brass.
To what?
To polish brass.
So it says Jesus Christ's arms and his feet was like in color to polish brass. Now we know that brass is brown. So how is this a white man's book if it's telling you that the greatest man to walk on the earth was in color to polish brass, which is black? That right there should let you know this is not a white man's book. We've been lied to. Read on.
And his eyes are lamps of fire, and his arms and his feet like in color to polish brass.
So Jesus Christ's arms and feet was like in color to polish brass, meaning Jesus Christ was a black man according to the Bible.
That's right.
Next slide. Now we're going to go further and prove it. Read this for me.
Revelation 1 and 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ.
Now this means the revealing of Jesus Christ. Read on.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass. And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
So he sent these things to show us. So read verse 13.
Verse 13, and in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man.
That says, one like unto the Son of Man. Now, everybody knows Jesus Christ. People call him the Son of Man. Read on.
Clothed with a garment down to the foot.
And Jesus Christ had a garment down to the foot. Read on.
And girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
And he had an award belt like we just read in the book of Daniel. Read on.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
And he says his head and his hairs were white like wool, meaning the hair on his head and the hair on his beard. Meaning he had a full head of grey hair and he had a grey beard. And this man right here, he doesn't have white hair. Read on.
As white as snow.
Read on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
It says, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, because he drank wine like we previously stated. Read on.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Hold on, what colour was his feet?
Like unto fine brass.
And it says his feet was like unto fine brass. Now we know that brass is brown, but we're going to go one step further. Read on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if the what?
As if they burned in a furnace.
So it said Jesus Christ was so dark, it was like his feet burned in a furnace. So I got a question for you. Which one, out of these two, which one looks more like Jesus Christ out of these two?
The one to the right.
The one to the right, exactly. The black man. Read that part again.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
And he said his feet was like unto fine brass.
Yeah.
Which means Jesus Christ was a black man. Read on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
It said Jesus Christ was so dark, it was like his feet burnt in a furnace. Now a furnace is like an oven. Next slide. Now, you got the white boy there, and this is a depiction of how it just described Jesus Christ. So this further proves it's not a white man's book. Because if it was a white man's book, it would have had this description in there.
That's right.
It would have had this homosexual in there if this was a white man's book. This man ain't nothing but a homosexual, but according to the Bible,
right,
Jesus Christ is a black man, which further proves this ain't no white man's book. Next slide. Read that for me.
Hebrews 10 and 7. Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me.
And Jesus Christ said he comes in the volume of the book, meaning he's all over the book from the beginning to the end, which means this is a black man's book. I mean, the black man's a star in this book. He said he comes in the volume of the book. So this book is about a black man, Jesus Christ, which further proves that this is a black man's book. We ain't seen, a white man in the book yet. Next slide. Now read that for me.
Exodus 2 and 16. Now the priest of Midian had 7 daughters, and they came and drew water and filled their troughs to water their father's flock.
Now he had 7 daughters and they came to water their father's flock. This was in Egypt, read on.
Verse 17, and the shepherds came and drove them away.
It says the shepherds came and drove them away. Read on.
But Moses stood up and held them.
And it says Moses stood up and helped them. So this part's key. It said Moses stood up and helped them. Read on.
And watered their flock. And when they came to Reuel, their father, he said, how is it that ye came so soon today?
So when they came back to their father, the father said, all right, how did you do this so quick? Read on.
Verse 19, and they said, an Egyptian delivered us.
Hold on, what did they say?
An Egyptian delivered us.
Now they said, an Egyptian delivered us. Now we know the Egyptians were black, and they mistook Moses for an Egyptian, which lets you know Moses was also a black man.
That's right.
They mistook Moses for an Egyptian, which lets you know Moses was a black man according to the Bible. Next slide. And it's easy. All the time people mistake us for Africans and so forth. I mean, this is Mavado. I mean, if you didn't know who Mavado was, you'd think Mavado was an African because he's all skinny and tall, and you'd look at him and think he's an African until you hear the accent. So the same way we mistake some of our people for Africans is the same way they mistook Moses for an Egyptian. Next slide. Now, this is Exodus 4, read this for me.
Exodus 4 and 6, and the Lord said furthermore unto him, put now thy hand in thy bosom.
Now, the Lord told Moses to put your hand in your bosom, meaning put your hand near his midsection, read on.
And he put his hand into his bosom, and when he took it out, behold, his hand was leprous as snow.
Now it says he put his hand in, and then once he put it in and took it out, his hand was leprous as snow, meaning his hand became white. Now if Moses was a white man, him putting his hand in his bosom, his hand would have been white before he put it in. When he took it out, his hand would have been white the whole time. Read on.
Verse 7, and he said, put thine hand into thy bosom again.
And the Lord told him, put your hand back into your bosom again. Read on.
And he put his hand into his bosom again, and plucked it out of his bosom, and behold, it was turned again as his other flesh.
And it says it was turned again as his other flesh. So now you have to think, okay then, if Moses put his hand in his bosom and it turned white, and then the Lord told him, okay, put it back in now, he put it back in, and then he took it back out and it went the color of his other flesh. You have to think, okay, what color was his other flesh? Now, in the last scripture we pulled, it said they mistook Moses for an Egyptian, and you know the Egyptians were black, which means Moses was obviously black. So far, you haven't seen a white man in the book. There's nowhere in this Bible which makes this a white man's book. In fact, God hates the white man, and we're going to pull that in a minute. What, next slide? Now, this is how Moses would have looked, and also, Moses is a black man who wrote the first 5 books. Moses wrote the book of Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, which means a black man wrote the law, because Moses was a black man who wrote the first 5 books of the law, which black people should follow. And because we don't follow the laws which a black man wrote, this is why we're in the condition that we're in. Next slide. Now, read that for me.
Deuteronomy 27 and 1, and Moses with the elders of Israel.
I said Moses was with the elders of Israel, meaning Moses was with Israelites only. Read on.
Commanded the people, saying, keep all the commandments which I command you this day.
And Moses was with the Israelites, and he said, keep these commandments which I command you this day. Now we're going to see what would happen to these people if they didn't keep which Moses commanded them. Next slide. Read that for me.
Deuteronomy 28 and 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day.
So it says, if you don't do all the Lord's laws, statutes, and commandments which he commanded us, read on.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
It says, all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Meaning, if you don't keep the laws, these is the things which is going to happened to the children of Israel. So we're going to see if the white man's the children of Israel or us, we're going to see who the curse is fit. Next slide. Read that for me.
Verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Now it says, therefore thou shalt serve thine enemies. Now, the white man ain't serving no enemies. The white man is the enemy.
That's right.
The white man is the enemy. He ain't serving no enemies. He's the one who runs the world. Read on.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Read on.
In hunger.
Meaning you have to go to the white man for food.
Read on. And in thirst.
You have to go to the white man for water, even though he's poisoning the water in Flint and so forth. Read on.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness, you have to go to him for clothes as well.
And in want of all things.
And anything you want, you have to go to the white man, whether it's a job, whether it's benefits and all of that stuff. You have to go to him in want of all things. Now, this prophecy only fits black people, because you know why? We have to go to all these other nations for everything. We don't really have anything of our own. Read on.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
And it says, and he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. Now, who had a yoke of iron on their neck during the time of slavery? Does anybody know?
We did.
Exactly. We had a yoke of iron upon our neck, which means these curses only fit us. Read on.
Until he have destroyed thee.
And they kept the yoke of iron on our neck until he was destroyed. And now it's off because we're destroyed. So now we don't know who we are. We don't know what to follow. We don't know where we're from. We don't know our culture, our language, our dress code, because we're destroyed. Now, we're the only people who don't know these things. All these other nations, they know these things. Next slide. Read that for me.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Now the word for Egypt is a Greek word for bondage. So it's saying basically the Lord is going to bring you into slavery with ships. Now, how did we go into slavery? Did we catch a plane? Did we go by free will? How did we get into slavery? Does anybody know? By ships. That only happened to us. So this is further stating that this is a black man's book, because these are the curses which happen to black people. Read on.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
And we went into slavery with ships. Read on.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
And we ain't seen our homeland as a nation again. Most people don't even know that their homeland is the land of Israel. You ask a black man where he's from, he's going to tell you about 10 different places.
That's right.
He's going to tell you about 10 different places. You ask a white man where he's from, he can tell you exactly where he's from. He can tell you, oh, I'm from Poland or wherever the devil's from, but read on.
And there ye shall be sold.
And it says, and there ye shall be sold. Now, who came off ships and was sold? The white man wasn't sold. The white man didn't go on no ships. Only we went on ships and was sold. Read on.
Unto your enemies.
And it says, we were sold unto our enemies. Now, who's our enemy? Our biggest enemy is the white man.
That's right.
And it says, we were sold unto him. Read on.
For bondmen.
For what?
For bondmen.
Now a bondman is a man which is a slave. Read on.
And bondwoman.
And bondwoman, meaning a woman which is a slave. And that only happened to us. And we still in slavery right now under the white man in a land that ain't ours. We don't even know where home is. Read on.
And no man shall buy you.
And that means no man shall redeem you. Now there's a lot of people who's tried to save black people and it hasn't worked. We're still in the same condition. Only Jesus Christ can save black people. Because Jesus Christ is a black man who loves his nation.
Right.
And if Jesus Christ was this white boy right here, we would be in slavery forever. We'd be getting our backs ripped forever. We'd be getting lynched forever. So we should be thanking God that Jesus Christ is a black man. Read on. Next slide. Now, this is a book by Rudolf R. Windsor. It's called From Babylon to Timbuktu. He's a historian. Next slide. Can you read that from there? Yeah, read that.
In the year
this is something which was written in the book of Babylon to Timbuktu. Read on.
In the year 65 BC, the Roman armies under General Pompey captured Jerusalem. In 70 AD, General Vespasian and his son Titus put an end to the Jewish state with great slaughter.
They put an end to the Jewish state with great slaughter, meaning murder. Read on.
During the period of the military governors of Palestine, many outrages and atrocities were committed against the residue of the people.
He says many atrocities were committed against the residue of the people. Now, even look today, they're still committing many atrocities against us right now. Read on.
During the period from Pompey to Julius, it is estimated that over 1 million Jews.
That said over 1 million Jews. Read on.
Fled into Africa.
It says 1 million Jews fled into Africa. And they fled into Africa to hide amongst dark races that looked similar in color to them. Read on.
fleeing from Roman persecution.
Fleeing from what?
Fleeing from Roman persecution.
And they was fleeing from the white man because he's been a murderer from the beginning of time.
Right.
So they
right.
was fleeing from the white man. And who flees from the white man today? Us, because he's still murdering us today. Nothing can change with him. Read on.
Fleeing Roman persecution and slavery. The slave markets were full of black Jewish slaves.
Oh, what color were the Jews?
Black Jewish slaves.
So if you don't want to believe it from the Bible, this is a history book saying that the slave market was full of black Jewish slaves, meaning the slave markets was full of black men and black women.
Next slide.
Now I'm gonna even show you out of the Bible that the angels was black. Read that for me.
Ezekiel 1:5. Also, out of the midst thereof came the likeness of four living creatures, and this was their appearance.
Now it says four living creatures. It says this was their appearance. That's gonna tell you the appearance of the angels in the Bible. Read on.
They had a likeness of a man.
And they had the likeness of a man. Read on.
And every one had four faces.
Read on.
And every one had four wings.
So they had four faces and four wings. Read on.
And their feet were straight feet.
Read on.
And the sole of their feet was like the sole of a calf's foot.
Read on.
And they sparkled like the colour of burnished brass.
Oh, what did these angels look like?
The colour of burnished brass.
So it says these angels was the colour of burnished brass. Now, you know, brass is brown, and it says burnished brass, meaning these angels were dark skinned. So when you're watching movies and stuff, you see some little white baby with a nappy and wings. That's not no angel. According to the Bible, the angels are black men. That white baby that you see with wings and that's the devil the Bible speaks of.
Right.
According to the Bible, the angels were black. Give me the next slide. Now this is the sons of Solomon. Read that for me.
Sons of Solomon.
Now this is the sons of Solomon. This is like a duet with Solomon and his women. Read on.
Chapter 1:1. The sons of Songs, which is Solomon.
So Solomon wrote the sons of Solomon, because this is like a duet between him and his wives. Read on.
Verse 5. I am black.
And he says, I am black. So Solomon there, he's saying he's black. Read on.
But comely.
And he said he's black but comely. Comely means beautiful. So here you got Solomon saying he's black but comely, which is further letting you know Solomon was a black man who wrote the sons of Solomon, which is showing you a black man wrote the sons of Solomon. Give me the next slide.
Sons of Solomon 1:10, thy cheeks are comely with rows of jewels.
Now this is one of Solomon's wives telling him, your cheeks are comely with rows of jewels. What she's basically saying is, Solomon had a mouthful of gold teeth. Now who has gold teeth today? Mostly black people have gold teeth today. The white man don't have gold teeth, and if he does, he's going to look stupid as hell. It don't suit him. So gold teeth only suits black people, and it says Solomon had a row of jewels in his mouth, meaning gold teeth. Solomon had a grill, like what do we call it today? Read on.
Thy neck with chains of gold.
And Solomon had chains of gold. Now Solomon was a Jew, and Solomon had gold teeth, and Solomon had gold chains. Now you don't see them white boys in Israel with gold teeth and chains on, because they ain't the real Jews. But the real Jews, they have gold teeth and chains, and that's what black people like to do, wear chains and have gold teeth. Give me the next slide. And Solomon had a girl like this, all gold like that. And Solomon had gold chains like that. I mean, us black people, we wear so much gold chains. You got rappers called Two Chains and stuff, because it's what we do. We like to look flashy and wear jewelry and stuff. Only black people do that, forever proving that this is a black man's book. Next slide. Read that for me.
Sons of Solomon 5:1. I am come into my garden.
Now this is Solomon talking. He's duetting with his wife. Read on.
My sister.
Now Solomon said he's coming to his garden. Now for every adult in the room, you know what that means. Read on.
My sister.
And only black people call each other brothers and sisters. The white men don't call each other that. Now only black people say, yeah, she's a sister, he's a brother. Only we talk like that. Solomon was talking the same thing back then. Read on.
My spouse.
So Solomon called his woman a sister, because only black people talk like that. The white man, he don't talk like that, further proving that this is a black man's book. But jump down to this part.
Songs of Solomon, chapter 4:5. Thy two breasts.
Now this is Solomon singing songs with his women. Read on.
Are like two young roes.
And this is Solomon saying to his woman, like two, he's singing to his woman saying, your two breasts are like two young roes. Now basically what Solomon's doing right here is, he's singing a Vibes Cartel song, believe it or not. That's what he's basically doing. Because only black people have flavor like that and sing songs like that. Solomon's basically doing the same thing here. Read on.
Which feed among lilies.
And Solomon's basically, you see them Vibes Cartel songs you hear? Solomon's basically doing the same thing here, singing with his rib. Next slide.
Songs of Solomon, chapter 5:15. His legs are as pillars of marble.
Now this is Solomon's wife saying Solomon's so strong because his legs are like pillars of marble. Now everyone knows what that means. You see today when women say, yeah, he's got a strong back. He can do he can do this, he can do it. The white men don't talk like that. This is Solomon, Solomon's wife saying, yeah, Solomon's got a strong back and his legs are so strong, they're like pillars of marbles. Meaning Solomon was putting that work in, basically. That's what it's basically saying. Give me the next slide. See, you see how Vibes Cartel sings all them songs like Ramping Shopping, that Solomon was singing those way before Vibes Cartel was. Now, we've been always singing songs like that. The white man, he don't do those things because the white man's just a homosexual and he don't know what it means to have sex with a woman, but we do. Next slide. Read that for me.
Proverbs 1 and 1. The proverb of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel.
That says, the Proverbs of Solomon, meaning Solomon was a black man who also wrote the book of Proverbs, and it says the son of David, which means if Solomon's black, obviously his father David's black, and David wrote the book of Psalms. So you even see people who ain't religious quoting Psalms and stuff, because them Psalms are powerful, and in them Psalms, that's how black people speak and stuff.
Verse 2, to know wisdom and instruction.
Solomon wrote Proverbs to know wisdom and instruction, and Solomon was the wisest man on the face of the earth. Which is a black man, but the white man don't want to tell you that a black man was the wisest man on the face of the earth, because he likes to lie to us and belittle us and make us believe we're stupid and we're nothing. But we proved that Solomon was black, and Solomon was the wisest man on the face of the earth, and Solomon wrote the book of Proverbs. Next slide. Read that.
Ecclesiastes 1 and 1, the words of the preacher, the son of David.
That is the words of the preacher, the son of David. Now the son of David is Solomon. So Solomon also wrote the book of Ecclesiastes. Next slide.
Isaiah.
Now I'm gonna show you some more cases in the Bible which only fits black people. Read on.
Moreover, the Lord saith, because the daughters of Zion are haughty and walk with stretched forth necks.
Now we know only black women walk with stretched forth necks. Their head all high in the air, thinking they run the world like Beyonce says and stuff. Read on.
And wanton eyes.
And what?
Wanton eyes.
And they want everything, they've got wanton eyes. Now this only fits our women, read on.
Walking and mincing as they go.
And they walk and mix as they go, meaning like they got a kind of walk that they do. Read on.
And making a tinkling with their feet.
And they make a tinkling with their feet. I mean when our women are walking in their heels, you can hear it from them a mile or 2 miles away. Read on.
Therefore the Lord will smite with a scab the crown of the head.
And it says, therefore the Lord will smite with a scab the crown of the head. Now this is why our sisters, I'm not knocking them, I'm saying this is why their hair, you know, this is why their hair don't grow too as long as it should do, because the Lord smited them with a scab that it doesn't grow long anymore because they was proud and haughty. Now, you know how you know this ain't a white man's book? Because the white woman's hair is damn long like Rapunzel's. Now, when you look at our sister's hair, it's not really that long, and that's why they have to put in extensions and weave and stuff. And this is in the Bible, this only fits our women. Read on.
The crown of the head of the daughters of Zion.
And it says the daughters of Zion. Now, when you look at our women, you can look at their hair and you can tell that, okay then, it's shorter than it should be. Read on.
And the Lord will discover their secret parts.
Read on.
In the day that the Lord will take away the bravery of their tinkling ornaments.
And this is, there was a time when our women used to rock a whole lot of jewelry and stuff. Read on.
About their feet and their claws, and their round tires like the moon.
And it says, and their round tires like the moon. Now here, when it says round tires, this is slang. Now, there was one time our women had the best bodies going. Now it says, read that part again.
And their round tires like the moon.
And it says, and the Lord will take that away, the round tires like the moon. Now that's slang. You see how when a brother sees a sister that's in shape, he says certain stuff like, yeah, she's got ends. What else does it say? She's got back. All of that kind of stuff. The Bible's basically saying the same thing. The Lord said he's going to take all that away. Now, you know this ain't talking about the white woman, because the white woman's as flat as anything. The white woman ain't got no body or nothing. So read on.
Verse 19, the chains and the bracelets and the mufflers.
And it says the brains and the mufflers, which was some jewelry that sisters used to wear in the 60s and stuff. Read on.
The bonnets and the ornaments of the legs and the headband and the tablets and the earrings.
And the Lord said he's going to take all that away. Read on.
The rings, the nose jewels.
And our sisters used to rock a whole lot of jewelry and nose studs and all of that stuff.
The changeable suits of apparel.
And the changeable suits of apparel. Now, Who likes to change their clothes all the time? It's only our women. They'll go to one club and have like 3-4 different outfits. Everywhere they go, they got on 3-4 different outfits. The Lord said, the changeable suits of apparel, only our women do that. They have like 1,000 pairs of shoes and so forth. Read on.
And the mantles and the wimples and the crisping pins, the glasses and the fine linen and the hoods and the veils.
Read on.
And it shall come to pass, instead of a sweet smell, there shall be stink.
Read on.
And instead of a girdle, a rent.
It says, instead of a girdle, a rent. Read on.
And instead of well-set hair.
It says, instead of well-set hair. Now, well-set hair is long hair. Read on.
Boldness.
Hold on. What did the Lord say he's going to give to the daughters of Israel?
Instead of well-set hair, boldness.
And this is why some of our sisters' hairs is so short. It's shorter than a damn grain of salt these days. But read that again.
And instead of well-set hair, boldness.
It says, instead of well-set hair, boldness. Now, this only fits our people. Now, when you look at white women, they've got long hair, but our women, they've got short hair because they didn't want to follow what the Lord was telling them to do. Read on.
And instead of a stomach cap, a girding of sackcloth, and a burning instead of beauty.
And a burning instead of beauty. This is, so, this is why she's got all this weave and stuff, because these curses fit us. Instead of well-set hair, boldness. And that's what happened to the daughters of Israel.
Next slide. Read that for me.
Job 30 and 30.
Now this is Job. I'm sure everyone's heard about the book of Job. Read on.
My skin is black upon me.
And Job said that his skin is black, meaning Job was also saying that he's a black man. So far, everything we've read, everyone in the Bible, they're telling you that they're black. No one hasn't told you that that they're white yet. So how could this be a white man's book if it's telling you that all the people in the Bible are black? Read on.
And my bones are burned with heat.
And I read that first one.
Job 1 and 1, there was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job, and that man was perfect.
And it said Job was black, and that's telling you that that man was perfect, meaning there is some thing as a black man being perfect. Now, the white man likes to make out his perfect and everything, when that's not true. Job told you that he was a black man, and here, the Lord said that Job was perfect. Read on.
And upright. And one that feared God.
And Job feared God. And Job was a black man, where it says here my skin is black. Job basically is telling you he's black.
Next slide. Now read Acts 13 and 1 for me.
Acts 13 and 1. Now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon.
And it says in Antioch there were certain prophets and teachers. So that's the key word, prophets and teachers. Read on.
That was called Niger.
That was called what?
Niger.
That was called what?
Niger.
They was called Niger. Now, if this is a white man's book, why did it say certain teachers and prophets were called Niger? Now, this is in the Bible. It says certain teachers and prophets were called Niger. Niger is a Latin word for black.
Get me the next slide where it's got the definition.
Now, this is the definition of Niger. It says in the English language, the word nigger is an ethnic slur usually directed at black people. The word originated as a neutral term referring to people with black skin. So it says that it referred to people with black skin. So they called the prophets Niger because obviously the prophets were black, which is letting you know that this is a black man's book. And it says, as a variation of the Spanish and Portuguese noun, Negro, a descendant of the Latin adjective Niger, meaning black. So these prophets in the book of Acts was called Niger. Prophets and teachers was called black. So the Lord called prophets and teachers, they was called black. And in the Bible, the white man's called the devil. So that should let you know that this ain't no white man's book. Next slide. Now this is Numbers chapter 12. Read that for me.
Numbers 12 and 9. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he departed.
Now this is when Miriam and Aaron were speaking against Moses. It says the Lord was angry at them for it, but read on.
Verse 10. And the cloud departed from off the tabernacle, and behold, Miriam became leprous.
Now it says, because the Lord was angry, the Lord turned her white. It says, Miriam became leprous. Read on.
White as snow.
She became white as snow. Read on.
And Aaron looked upon Miriam, and behold, she was leprous.
Aaron looked upon her, and she was white. It was like, damn, the Lord turned her white because he was angry at her. And that's why the white man's white, because the Lord's angry at him. Read on.
And Aaron said unto Moses, alas, my Lord, I beseech thee.
And Aaron went to Moses and begged him. Read on.
Lay not this sin upon us.
And Aaron begged the Lord and said, lay not this sin upon us, letting you know that it's a sin to be white. Now, if this was the white man's book, why is Aaron saying, lay not this sin upon us, meaning it's a sin to be white? Read on.
Wherein we have done foolishly, and wherein we have sinned.
Read on.
Let her not be as one dead.
Now, the Lord turned the white. So Aaron was saying, let her not be as one dead. Basically saying the white man, he looks half dead. So basically the white man's the walking dead, he looks half dead. Now, if this was a white man's book, why would they say to be turned white is sin?
That's right.
Why would they say to be turned white is sin if this is a white man's book? This further proves that this isn't a white man's book. This further proves that that the white man is the devil and being white is a sin. That's what this proves. Read on.
Of whom the flesh is half consumed.
And whom the flesh is what?
Half consumed.
That's the white man. Read on.
When he cometh out of his mother's womb.
Next slide. Now this is the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. Next slide. Now, in the Bible, the white man is Esau, Edom. Now read this.
Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. Edom figures prominently in prophetic scriptures as the scene of great future judgment.
So if this is a white man's book, why is it saying in the future the white man's got the white man's getting some judgment? If this was a white man's book, it wouldn't say that. Read on.
She is the only neighbor of the Israelites who was not given any promise of mercy.
Hold on, the white man was not what?
Not given any promise of mercy from God.
And it says this was the only nation who was not given any mercy from God. Meaning there's a time coming when the Lord's going to destroy the white man. Now if this was the white man's book again, why would it say this in there? That the Lord ain't giving them no mercy? Read on.
Also Obadiah verse 18. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stubble.
And Esau is going to be for stubble. Read on.
And they shall kindle in them and devour them.
And do what?
And devour them.
And do what?
And devour them.
And the Lord said we're going to devour the white men. Read on.
And there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau.
And here it's saying there shall not be remaining of any of the house of Esau. Meaning the white man's going to be wiped out completely and utterly destroyed. So if this was a white man's book, it wouldn't say all that in there. Further proving that this ain't a white man's book that we've been lied to. Read on.
For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it.
And the Lord spoke these words. The Lord spoke these words. Next slide.
Genesis 25 and 25.
This is the beginning of the white man. Read it.
And the first came out red, all over like.
Now it says the first came out red, meaning the white man. He came out red. Really, they're red, but the different shades of red. That's the color that they are. Read on.
All over like a hairy garment.
And when you look at some images of the white man when he was in them caves, he was hairy as hell. Read on.
And they called his name Esau.
And they called his name Esau. So remember, Esau's red. Now read this for me.
Revelation 12 and 13. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon.
See, it said the word red again. It said a great red dragon. Now, this ain't literally a dragon. This is how black people talk. The reason it calls him a dragon is because, like you see how dragons fly and breathe down fire on people? That's what the white man does with his warplanes when he drops bombs on people. So it's referring to him as a dragon. But when a white man's teaching you the Bible, he literally believes that there's going to be a great red dragon, which doesn't make no sense. It's referring to the white man according to his characteristics and stuff. Read on.
Having 7 heads and 10 horns.
Read on.
And 7 crowns upon his head. And
that's just talking about his military might and stuff. Read the next one.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent.
It says the great dragon was cast out, meaning the white man, that old serpent. Meaning the dragon at one time was the serpent. What's the serpent? A snake. Now, if you're learning from a white man, he's going to tell you the snake in Genesis is a literal snake, that a snake was talking. Because this is a black man's book and we speak slang, it's like if someone's a snitch, you call them a rat. It doesn't literally mean they're a rat. If someone's conniving and sly and slick, you call them a snake. And that's why the white man was called the serpent in the book of Genesis, because he possesses those characteristics. He's slick and he's sly. It doesn't literally mean he's a serpent. But because white people don't understand slang, that's why they read the Bible that way. Read on.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
Called the what?
Called the devil.
Called the what?
Called the devil.
So if this is the white man's book, why is it calling the white man the devil? If this was his book, why would it call him the devil in his own book? Further letting you know that this ain't his book. Read on.
And Satan.
And it called him Satan as well, because the white man is the devil and Satan. Read on.
Which deceiveth the whole world.
Now it says, and he deceiveth the whole world. Now you know how you know it's not talking about a little dragon? Because when did you see a dragon down here, a red dragon with 7 heads deceiving the whole world? Now you know who deceives the whole world? The white man.
That's right.
With his religions, Christianity, his homosexuality. He tells you his alternative lifestyle. He tells you you're free to have abortions and do whatever you want. He makes you believe that he's the real Jew.
He makes you believe that he's the people of the Bible, the Bible's his book and so forth, and he deceived the whole world. Now when you look at who deceived the whole world, only the white man's done that.
Which
is further letting you know the white man's the devil and Satan. That's out of the Bible. Read the next slide.
Psalms 83.
No, this is Psalms 83, read on.
Psalms 83 and 1. Keep not thou silence, O God. Hold not thy peace, and be not still, O God.
Now, David wrote these Psalms, a black man. He was telling the Lord, hold not your peace, and don't be still, read on.
For lo, thine enemies.
And he says, thine enemies, meaning our enemies, read on.
Make a tumult.
And he says, our enemies, they all come together and make an agreement, read on.
And they that hate thee.
And he says, and they that hate thee, because all these other nations hate the Israelites, which is us, read on.
Have lifted up their head.
And they lifted up their head, meaning they've become proud and all this stuff, read on.
They have taken crafty counsel.
And they've taken crafty counsel, they've taken very crafty counsel, and the crafty counsel that they've took is work, because they've cut us off from who we really are, read on.
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
And they've consulted against thy hidden ones. We those hidden ones, read on.
They have said, come and let us cut them off.
And they said, come and let us cut them off, read on.
From being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
Now they all came together and said, let us cut them off, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. So now when you speak to most black people, you ask them where you're from, they ain't gonna tell you, oh, I'm an Israelite. You're gonna get loads of different answers. Some are gonna say African, Jamaican, Puerto Rican. Some are gonna say I'm Haitian and so forth, because they've cut us off that the name of Israel is no more in remembrance. Because we the children of Israel, but because the white man's a devil who took crafty counsel against us, he's cut us off from knowing who we are. Now if this was his book, this wouldn't be in his book telling us these things. Now this is our book, and that's why it's telling us these things, that they took crafty counsel against us. And this forever proves that this is our book, because we don't know who we are. We don't know we're the Israelites. If I was to ask, if I was to go on the road and ask 10 black people your nationality, I'll get 10 different answers, because right. They've cut us off from being a nation.
Next slide.
Now, this is how they deceived the whole world. Now, Jesus is a white boy now. When we read in the Bible that Jesus Christ was black, now they deceived the whole world by putting up this white boy. Now, as a black man, when you're going through hard times, you close your eyes, who do you see? This white boy. You pray, who do you see? This white boy. Times get hard, who do you see when you pray? This white boy. When this white boy is the devil, this white boy is the reason why you're in slavery.
That's right, right.
This white boy is the reason why God ain't listening to you. You pray to a white man who hates you. this white man is the reason why you're in slavery. This white man is the same reason why we love white people, because we've been taught, okay then, Jesus is white, so we think, okay, because Jesus is white, we have to love them, when really, Jesus Christ is a black man and this man's the devil. You should hate to see this image. Because even our kids, ask your kids, what color is Jesus? They're going to tell you, oh, Jesus is white. Even in schools, when kids have their nativity plays, you never see a black kid get to play Jesus. It's always some disgusting white kid that's Jesus. Some next white kid that's Joseph. I remember when I was in primary school, I asked them, can I play Jesus? The teacher, the next day, the part that I had to play, I had to just stand and hold the arrow like this. And when really, I should have played Jesus, because I was the only black man in the play. And they made the white man play Jesus, which further deceives the whole world.
Give me the next slide. Is that too small for you to read off there?
You're going to
forget the crowd. go back a slide. And this is what they gave us, this cross to worship. So we walk around with this cross in our neck. We follow everything the white man does. Now, because we don't know our culture, we've took on the white man's culture. We don't know our heritage. We've took on the white man's. The black men don't even know what his language is. If you're around the East Indian, whenever their parents phone them, they start speaking in their language. Whenever you're around someone Chinese and their parents call, they speak in their language. Whenever you're around the African, even they speak in their language, and so forth. But when you're around a black man like yourself and his parents phone, we speak in English. You know why? Because we don't know our language. Because it was taken from us. They took crafty counsel to cut us off. Next slide. Can you read that? You can't read it. Oh, one second. Let me read it. I'm gonna have to read it on your phone.
Trying to tell
you that. No, I think you said I'm too small on the side. Don't worry, I'll shoot it from there. Now, this is out of a book called Who is Esau Edom? It says, there is not one favorable or positive statement in the Bible in relation to Esau Edom, meaning there's nothing positive in the Bible about the white man. says, but how does this adverse relationship which God has towards Esau Edom help us to identify who this character is in the world today? It says, to help us answer this, we have to put ourselves in the role which Esau has been assigned in God's script. It says, if God hated you and your ancestors, how would you react and what would you do? It says, by natural reaction, you would be against God. Now, who's against God? The white man. Everything that God says to do, the white man does everything opposite to God, because he knows that God hates him. And it says, by natural reaction, you'll be against God and his people and try to prevent them from finding out you are Esau. So that's what the white man does. He hides who he really is. How does he hide himself? He tells you that he's the real Jew and so forth. And it says, Esau, the one God is against, knowing that if God is against something, so will his followers. It says, who is it that tries to conceal their identity as Edom, the one hated by God, by claiming to be Israel? Now, who claims to be Israel? The white man. You know why? Because they know God hates them. So they claim to be Israel and they lie to us and tell us we're something else when really we're the children of Israel. And there's a next slide that says, God's hatred of Edom is not a temporary thing, but it's perpetual, meaning God hates Esau forever and ever and ever. It says the doctrine that God loves everyone does not stand up in light of what the Bible has to say regarding God's merciless position towards the race of people called Edom. It says, although the churches have tried to alter God's true nature, we find that throughout the Bible, God's position towards Esau, Edom does not change, meaning God hates the white man forever. This is a white man who wrote this book who's telling you that God hates the white man forever. And this is a book, it's a good book to get, who is Esau, Edom. Also, there's a next one. It quotes the scripture, Romans 9 and 13. It says, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, and Jacob is the father of the 12 tribes of Israel, which is us. And it says, but Esau have I hated. So in the Bible, it's telling you that God hates the white man. So if this was the white man's book, it wouldn't say, if this was the white man's book, why would it say that God hates him in his own book? Further proving that this isn't a white man's book. God hates the white man. And it says, this hatred by God towards Esau is an attribute that the human heart cannot accept or embrace. And therefore, many will try to explain it away. And this is why when you go to church, you ask them about that verse to try to explain it away and tell you some next nonsense which don't make no sense. But all throughout the Bible, God hates the white man and it's not going to change. It says, thus scores of theologians have avoided this truth of scripture or have whitewashed it into something more appealing to human nature. It says, God not only hates Esau, Edom, and is against these people, but refers to them as the people of my curse. It says, the curse is not just on Esau, but also his seed and his brethren. Meaning, God hates the white man forever. God hates the white man. Down to those little white babies that come out the womb, God hates them too. God hates all white people. That's what it's basically saying. Next slide. Now, this is Job chapter 9, verse 24. Read this for me.
Job 9, 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
It says the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Now, who rules the earth? It says the earth's given into the hand of the wicked. Now, you know, the white man rules the earth. So, obviously, he's the wicked. Read on.
He covereth the faces of the judges thereof.
And he covers the faces of the judges. How does he cover the faces of the judges? He makes himself the top judge in the face of the earth. He makes himself the Israelites. He makes himself Jesus Christ. He makes himself all the prophets in the Bible. And it says the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. So all you have to do is see who runs the earth and see who's the wicked. And you see it's the white man. Now, if this is the white man's book, it wouldn't say the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. This is written in here for black people to read and understand who the wicked on the face of the earth is. Next slide. Now, this is a white man whitewashing images. This is basically a man covering the faces of the judges as we speak. So they whitewash images. And this is how Jesus Christ went from looking like that to looking like this. Because they whitewash these images. Read 1 Maccabees 3:48.
1 Maccabees 3:48. And laid open the book of the law, wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images.
So they paint the likeness of their images. So every time you look at Bible characters, they're always white. When you watch these biblical movies, they're always white. When you watch The Passion of the Christ, it's a white man, because they laid open the book of the law. They took this Bible and they painted all these Bible characters white. And pictures speak volumes. So when black people see pictures, they automatically think, okay then, Jesus Christ is white, so this is a white man's book. Never ever read the book, but when you read the book, it tells you that Jesus Christ is a black man, which further proves the white man is the devil and he deceived the whole world. Next slide. Read that for me.
Psalms 50 and 16. But unto the wicked,
God says, but unto the wicked, Now in the last scripture we read, it said the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, meaning the white man runs the earth. Now here, God's talking to the wicked, read on.
But unto the wicked, God saith, what hast thou to do to declare my statutes?
And God's saying to the white man, who are you to declare my statutes? God's saying to the white man, why do you even have a Bible? Who are you to have a Bible? The Lord didn't give his statutes to them, so the Lord's asking the wicked, which is the white man, who are you to declare my statutes? Read on.
Or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth.
And the Lord don't even want the white man to take his covenant in his mouth. The Lord don't even want the white man to own a Bible. It's wrong that the white man even has a Bible, because it's a black man's book. The white man shouldn't even have a Bible.
Next slide. Read this for me.
Psalms 147 and 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob.
It says he shows his word unto Jacob, meaning Jacob is the forefather of the Israelites. Read on.
And his statutes and judgments unto Israel.
And it says he showed his statutes and his judgments unto Israel, meaning he gave his laws to us. So a black man is supposed to keep these laws in the Bible, because it was given to black people. And this is why I'm in the condition we're in, because we didn't keep these statutes which the Lord gave to us. Read on.
Verse 20. He have not dealt so with any nation.
It says God has not dealt so with any nation, meaning he ain't dealt with nobody else. He hasn't gave nobody else his laws, his statutes and commandments. He ain't dealt with these other nations, because he don't care about these other nations. Let the white man be a homosexual all he wants, that's up to him. But if you're a black man, you ain't allowed to be those things, because the Lord gave you laws and statutes.
Right.
Read on.
And as for his judgments, they have not known them. And
as for his judgments, they have not known them. The white man, he don't know the Lord's judgments, because it wasn't given to him. It was only given to the Israelites. Read on.
Praise ye the Lord.
Next slide. Read that for me.
This is the book of Obadiah. This is a beautiful book. This is this is a very beautiful book. Read it.
Obadiah 1 and 8. Shall I not in that day, saith the Lord, even destroy the wise men out of Edom?
It says in that day the Lord is going to destroy the wise men out of Edom. Read on.
And understanding out of the mount of Esau.
The Lord's going to destroy the white men out of the mount of Esau, meaning the top ones, the low ones, etc. Read on.
And thy mighty men, O Teman, shall be dismayed, to the end that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter.
It says every one of them may be cut off by slaughter, meaning all of them are going to get put to death. Now if this was a white man's book, why does it say that every white man's going to be cut off by slaughter? Forever proving it's not a white man's book.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob.
For thy what?
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob.
It says for thy violence against thy brother Jacob, because Jacob and Esau was brothers. Now we Jacob, Esau's the white man. Now who's been the most violent to black people in the face of the earth? Someone give me the answer.
The white man.
To who?
The white man.
Exactly, the white man. He's been violent to black people. And the Bible's telling you this right here, for your violence against Jacob, meaning when they lynched us and all of that, murdered us, had to shoot us dead in the streets. All of this is written in the Bible. But when you go to church, when you go to church, they don't teach you these things in church. Read on.
Shame shall cover thee.
Shame shall what?
Shall cover thee.
And shame is going to cover the white man. So every week we are on the street telling the white man he's the devil. Shame covers him. To turn bright red and say, oh, it wasn't me who enslaved you. But it doesn't matter. The Lord's going to destroy all of them. You know why? Because the Lord loves his children, the children of Israel, and he's going to destroy the white man who's the devil. Read on.
And thou shalt be cut off forever.
He says they're going to be cut off forever. So the Lord's going to wipe them out completely. Next slide. Now this is, can you read that for me?
Aye. They left black the war for Israel.
This was the Egyptian president. This is what he said. Read it.
When he was asked about peace in the Middle East.
Now this president was asked about peace in the Middle East. Read.
The late president of Egypt, Gamal Abdel Nasser, stated.
And this is what he stated. Read.
The Jews will never be able to live here in peace.
And he said the white Jews will never be able to live in the Middle East in peace. Why? Read on.
Because they left here black.
Oh, now what color did the Jews leave?
They left here black.
So he even said the Jews left the Middle East black. Read on.
But come back white.
So he said the Jews left the Middle East black and came back white. Which is letting you know that once we was out of the land of Israel, the white man went into the land of Israel and started to claim that he's a Jew. This is a president telling you this. Basically what he's saying is the same thing the Bible's saying, that the real Jews are black and the white Jews are imposters. He's telling you the same thing which is written in the Bible. Next slide. Read this for me.
Revelations 2 and 9. I know thy works and tribulation and poverty.
This is Jesus Christ saying to the real Israelites, which is us, the so-called blacks and Hispanics, saying, I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, because he knows what we're going through. He knows our struggles and so forth. Read on.
But thou art rich.
And it says, but thou art rich. The reason we're rich is because we're the children of God, and all these promises in the Bible is for us. Read on.
And I know the blasphemy.
And it says, and I know the blasphemy. A blasphemy is a wicked lie. Read on.
Of them which say they are Jews.
And it says, I know the wicked lie of them which say they are Jews. Now, who says the Jews? The white man in the land of Israel with his yarmulke, he says he's a Jew. And Jesus Christ said he knows the blasphemy of them, which is a wicked lie. Read on.
And are not.
And are what?
And are not.
And Jesus Christ is saying he knows the wicked lie of them who say they are Jews and they're not Jews. Read on.
But are the synagogue of Satan.
And who?
The synagogue of Satan.
Jesus Christ said they're the synagogue of Satan, further proving that this ain't no white man's book, because here it's telling you that them fake Jews are the synagogue of Satan. Read Revelations 3 and 9.
Revelation 3 and 9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews.
So he said, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews. Read on.
And are not.
And are not. So he even went further and said, they say they're Jews, but they're not Jews. So that should be clear to all the people in the room that the white man is not a Jew. Read on.
What do lie?
What what?
What do lie?
And that's all the white man does is do lie. The white man's been lying from the time of Genesis. The white man's been a liar all along. Read on.
Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet.
And Jesus Christ is going to make them come and worship at our feet. The white man's going to be on his knees, bowing down to us. Read on.
And to know that I have loved thee.
And they're going to come down and bow down to us. And Jesus Christ is going to let them know, listen, we the real Israelites, and it's us who is loved all this time. Because we don't know who we are. You know why? Because we've been taught that they're the real Jews, when really we the real Jews. And Jesus Christ is going to make them bow down at our feet. And damn, that's going to be a beautiful day. Next slide. Now, these are the so-called white Jews. Now, what we read in the Bible so far, we read that the Jews are black. How the Jews had flavor and style. They had gold teeth and gold chains. Now, these white Jews as basic as they could be. As basic as they could be, wearing suits and ties. And it also says Judah mourneth. And the gates thereof languish, meaning there's no protection. These guys have got all the protection in the world. They're damn sitting down with, is that President Bush?
Yeah.
They're damn sitting down with President Bush and that. You ain't gonna see no black Jews with President Bush. You know, because alligators languish. Read on. Read this for me.
Revelation 13 and 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear.
That basically means if any man can understand this. Read on.
Verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity.
It says, he that leadeth into captivity. Now, we was led into captivity by the white man, read.
Shall go into captivity.
So, because he led us into captivity, when Jesus Christ returns, they're going to go into captivity. Read on.
He that killeth with the sword.
And it says, he that killeth with the sword, they're murdering us left, right, and center. Read on.
Must be killed with the sword.
And it says, he that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. So, the same way they kill us, they're going to have to die the same way. Read on.
Here is the patience and faith of the saints.
And the Lord said, here is the patience and faith of the saints, meaning the saints are waiting for this thing to happen. Meaning, in order to be a saint, you got to be patient. In order to be a saint, you got to want the destruction of the white men. You got to want the white men to go into captivity. It says, here is the faith and the patience of the saints. Next slide. Now, read this for me. This is about Paul, read.
Acts 21, 37. And Paul was led into the castle. He said unto the chief captain, may I speak unto thee? Who said, canest thou speak Greek?
So Paul asked him, can I speak to you? And he goes to your surprise and said, oh, you can speak Greek. Read on.
Verse 38, art not thou that Egyptian?
Further proving that Paul was a black man, because they mistook Paul for an Egyptian as well. Now, there's no way you could mistake a white man for an Egyptian. They mistook Paul for an Egyptian because there was the same in color. Read on.
Which before these days made us an uproar, and led us out into the wilderness 4,000 men that were murderers.
Read the next slide.
But Paul said, I am a man which am a Jew.
So Paul said, no, I'm not an Egyptian, I'm a man which am a Jew. So they mistook Paul for an Egyptian, and Paul said, no, I'm a man which is a Jew. So if you know that the Egyptians were dark-skinned people, and they mistook Paul for one of them, that's letting you know that Paul was dark-skinned himself, and Paul was black himself, which further proves it ain't no white man's book. Next slide. Now, Paul also wrote this, this is Acts chapter 7, read this.
Acts 7 and 57. Then they cried out with a loud voice, and stopped their ears, and ran upon him with one accord.
Now, this is what black people do, read on.
And cast him out into the city, and stoned him.
This is talking about when they stoned Stephen, read on.
and the witnesses laid down their clothes.
Now before they stoned him, they laid down their clothes. Now what do black people do when we're about to fight? We take off our coats, off our jewelry, off our rings. And you know how you know this is talking about a black man? Because I've had to take off my coat a few times. That's how you know this is talking about a black man. Next slide. Now, read that.
Romans 11 and 1. I say then, have God cast away his people?
So it says, has God cast away his people? Because the conditions we're living in now, people say, oh, God's done away with Israel and so forth. God's done away with us and so forth. People say, read on.
God forbid.
It says, God forbid, meaning how long? Read on.
For I also am an Israelite.
And Paul said, no, God ain't done away with his people because I'm an Israelite also. Read on.
Of the seed of Abraham.
He said, it's from the seed of Abraham. Read on.
Of the tribe of Benjamin.
He said, it's from the tribe of Benjamin. Now, who's the tribe of Benjamin today? So-called West Indies, like people like Bounty Killer. So lucky I can't remember which one, Sizzler or Capleton. Capleton's also from the tribe of Benjamin, Sizzler, and so forth, Vibes Cartel and such. So most people in this room are from the tribe of Benjamin. Paul also was from the tribe of Benjamin. Give me the next slide. And also, Paul was a black man. Paul wrote all these books. So Paul wrote the book of Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews. So we proved that Paul was black, and Paul wrote all these books showing you that a black man wrote most of the books in the New Testament. Because if Paul was black and Paul wrote these books, that forever proves it's not a white man's book, it's a black man wrote these books.
And the Ancient of Days did sick.
He says, the Ancient of Days did sick. He calls God the Ancient of Days because he was here before days existed. Read on.
Whose garment was white as snow.
So God had on a white garment. Read on.
And his hair, and the hair of his head, like the pure wool.
And he said God had hair like pure wool. This is talking about the Heavenly Father. He had hair like pure wool. Give me the next slide. I got the definition of wool. Now this is hair like pure wool. Now it says, English dictionary, this is a noun, the soft, thick hair that grows in the body. Now, and the head. So basically, the Lord, the Heavenly Father had hair like this. Now, only black people have hair like that. It says his hair was thick. Only black people have thick hair. And if you remember being younger, every time your parents used to call you to comb your hair, you probably hide behind the settee and stuff because your hair's thick and it hurts and so forth. The Lord had thick hair as well. So this is out of the Bible saying that God had thick hair like this. Only black people have hair like this. The white man's hair is stringy, he don't have thick hair. Next slide.
Deuteronomy 9 and 9. When I was gone up into the mount to receive the tables of stone, even the tables of the covenant which the Lord made with you, then I abode in the mount 40 days and 40 nights. I neither did eat bread nor drink water.
So this is talking about when Moses went up to the mount. Read it.
And the Lord delivered unto me 2 tables of stone written with the finger of God.
Meaning the 10 commandments. Now we just showed you that God is also black according to the Bible. And it says the 10 commandments was written with the finger of God. Meaning that a black man took his finger and wrote these 10 commandments. Forever proving this is a black man's book. Next slide. Read this for me.
2 Timothy 3 and 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God.
It says all scripture is given by inspiration of God. Which means if God's a black man, it means a black man gave you these scriptures, which makes this a black man's book. Read on.
And profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness.
So a black God gave you this book. So for instruction in righteousness, for us to be righteous, that's why he gave us this book. Next slide. Read on.
Isaiah 34, 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read.
And it says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. Now we proved everyone in the book was black. We proved that even God was black himself. And it says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord. So if the Bible's the book of the Lord, I got a question for you. If the Bible's the book of the Lord and we proved that God was black, who does this book belong to? Well, but you know, if you don't know, we can go up to the start of the lecture and do it again.
Black people.
Exactly. So this is a black God saying, seek ye out of the book of the Lord, meaning this is his book, which makes this the black man's book. Next slide. And with that, we say shalom. That's the end of my slide. Yeah. Oh, yeah, also, we got a donation bucket as well. If anyone would like to drop any donations in and come and support this truth. And next up, we're going to. We're going to have a little break, and then the brother Karafi is up next with his topic. When nowadays I work hard on the job, till I come cross y'all, still like I'm a criminal.
what you tell the kids. We try to put up a fight, but did we fail the kids? Cause they really got us looking like no damn good. And why success got to cost my manhood? Hey, black women, y'all got to wake the fuck up. Cause some of y'all